Okay, Sex on Fire. That's just quite quick and easy song to learn if you've got a depth for it. It's built around just two chords, E and C sharp minor. There are other notes implied by the bass guitar, but the guitars are generally always doing something to do with E and C sharp minor. Caleb, that's the hairy guy, he starts it with this little riff. Using the bottom E as a pedal tone and sliding from C sharp to B. And then he's moving the inversion to C sharp and sliding from the A to the G sharp. If you're wondering why he plays it so high up the neck, it's because he hurt his shoulder apparently and he couldn't move his arm. So your intonation's got to be pretty good, and these strings are older than me. So mine's a little well, but never mind. That's his part for the intro and his part for the verse. His part for the chorus is also really simple. It's just octave E's sliding up to octave G sharps and then sliding back to E again. So he keeps an open E droning, some octave E's, and then he takes it up to G sharp in this kind of fashion for the chorus. So I've got an open E as a drone, octave E, high octave E. I'm muting everything else. And that's what he does in the chorus, and it's the bass guitar dropping to the C sharp that gives the chorus that melancholy sort of sound. And that's Caleb's parts for the whole song. That's it for him. So if you're covering from him, you can stop the lesson now. The other guy, he comes in when the drums kick in, and he comes in on a C sharp minor in a kind of reggae upstroke fashion. So drums kick in and he kicks in with. And can you see there's a grace note of B every couple of bars? So every time he changes, and at the end of every two bars, he puts a little grace note, so it's. In that kind of fashion. And then it goes quiet, and the verse goes all melancholy, and then he comes in with this nice little bit. If I just do that slowly, he's starting on an A, dropping to G sharp, F sharp, coming back up to B and D sharp. His part for the chorus is the most obvious part you hear straight away. He keeps an E string droning and he plays this kind of thing. So I'm starting on the E there with an open E string ringing, sliding up to B with an open string ringing, putting on a little cheeky D sharp, going back to G sharp and keeping the E string ringing, And then your kind of typical bluesy rock kind of bend from the B string up to the note that's on the E string. So we're bending a C sharp up to a D sharp and hitting a D sharp here. And then we're bending a B up to a C sharp and hitting a C sharp here. And then we're hitting the D sharp one again. And then landing on a little E triad. So I'm actually hitting E, G sharp, and my open E again. So I'll just do that again slowly. And that's his part for the chorus. And the only other thing that happens in the song is the last chorus, the second half of it, everything stops bar the kick drum, and we stab on the chords in this kind of fashion. And then we all kick back in. And that kind of thing. And that's pretty much the whole song. So what I'll do now is I'll play along with the song and I'll alternate between all three parts so you can see where they fit in the song. Thank you. only other thing to add, if you're doing it with one guitar and you've got to basically try and cover more than one of the parts, you've got to start with this bit, obviously. But you can try and tack on a bit of a chord on the end of it to give this sort of effect. And when it comes to the melancholy part, instead of you could do what I normally do, which is something like this. Generally fills it out a bit more, and when it comes to the chorus, you can stick on a couple of extra notes to do with E in that kind of fashion. So instead of just doing that, you kind of go on. Maybe a bit better than that. Anyhow, there you go, Sex on Fire. Next week, Superstition.